If you want to get it done, you have to do it yourself. That's what I hear from so many business owners, and they think it's real and true. You know, but if you think about it, you know, no matter what problems you have in life, you always have a choice. You can struggle in solitude, or you can take the shortcut and learn from someone else who can help you get there and take the path of least resistance. I mean, the good news is that success always leaves clues. So we can just follow other people, see what they've done, and see what they've done to solve their problems, and do what they do. It's that easy. So one of the things that I realized when I was working with Alice, she was a bottleneck in her business. We quickly realized that she's working extremely hard, working 12 to 16 hour days, and she has one staff and she's helping out. But that's not enough. And Alice is working and working and working. Why? Because she believes she can do it better. She takes what her team does and then improves it on that pattern all the time, making improvements to the work that's being done by her team. But what about having a team that's really good at what they do and Alice doesn't have to improve their work all the time, doesn't have to redesign? What about that? What about training them to get them focused and dialed in and doing what they do best and getting the best people? Somebody who's like a junior version of herself. Well, guess what? That's what we did. We found people that were so good at what they did in the design aspect and the technology and so on, and they could do that work without her involvement. And in the end, she was able to step back, let her team do the work, maybe make some final tweaks to projects here and there, but not every single one. And that turn things around for her. So instead of saying to herself that I have to do it myself all the time, my team can't do it right, that's a mindset, that's a focus, and it's going to produce horrible results because it's going to cause a lot of work for her, for Alice, and it's going to cause a lot of confusion because it's a bottleneck. And ultimately, she wanted a business that's going to provide her with the freedom to do what she wanted. She was not free. She was chained to her business and tied to it. And I know you don't want that. So think about it the next time you say to yourself, I can do it better. Or they're not doing it quite as good as I would. You know, that just means you haven't selected the right team and you haven't followed what other people are doing. Because if you ask who, not how, instead who knows how to do this and follow them and do what they did, then you can succeed for sure. So don't let this myth stop you anymore and don't be the bottleneck in your business like Alice was. Otherwise, you're going to get to a point where she was almost burning out. This myth is everywhere. I've seen it with all sorts of entrepreneurs and now you can do something about it. Now you know better.